Welcome to Launching the Pilot with your hosts, Brian and Paul.
In the pilot episode 123.
Season.
1, 2, 3.
Testing. Is anyone there?
Hello there, Outer Hebrides, isn't it? Whatever. Civilization.
Well, I was looking at our stats today, and 50% of our downloads.
Well, I've lost weight.
50% of our downloads are from America.
Are they?
Yeah, so you've got to be nice to the Americans.
Oh,
now.
It's not going to happen.
Yeah. And they've got guns and everything.
Yeah, it's not going to happen.
So this week we're doing War of the Worlds, the TV series.
Was this the one set in England, like the original book?
Well, strangely, they've changed the setting slightly.
Oh, well, there you go. Where's this one set?
America. Where we get most of our downloads from. This is 1988.
Are these the people that believed when... Awesome Wells read it and it's happening.
Are anybody still alive from that time? So this is 1988 to 1990. Two seasons.
Yeah,
43 episodes.
I'll give you that.
The first one was in two parts or one part, depending on how you look at it. The Resurrection, it's called. And in the first season, all the titles were biblical, did you know?
No.
No, well, you wouldn't. Well, we didn't watch any more than the first one.
Right, exactly. So there you go.
And it stars Gerard Martin as Harrison Blackwood, and we know him from,
because I've written it down here, Fantasy Island.
That's where we know.
And is it Fantasy Island? No, Fantastic Voyage.
Yeah, I always get two mixed
Journey.
Up as well. Yeah,
Fantastic Journey. Journey, not Voyage.
Racker Welsh, that's who he played. Was he Varion? Was it the Varion? Vernon.
Yeah.
No, he had a futuristic name because he was from the 24th century.
Oh, yeah.
Dave.
Donald.
No, that's not futuristic. That's going backwards. Anyway, also starred Linda Mason Green.
Probably. I have no idea who it starred.
Suzanne, I think, McCourga.
Oh, yeah, I know who you mean.
Yeah, her.
Yeah.
Philip Akin as Norton Drake. And this is my favourite. Richard Chaves as Colonel Paul Ironhorse.
Oh yeah, Ironhorse, yeah, I know.
Oh, sorry, Lieutenant Commander.
get me Ironhorse. If Rambo's not available.
He would definitely be the second choice.
Oh, any time.
I've got, it starts off like Highwayman, a big truck.
Yeah, I've got lorry pulls out of some army facility.
Yeah.
Because this is the problem. I write these notes, and then 2 seconds later, it's quite obvious where they were.
Yes. Yeah, it tells you.
But I didn't know that at the time of writing the note.
And there's no way I'm stopping to rechange the notes.
Okay, so at this moment, we're at an army facility, and it's night.
Military base, night time. I've got the soldiers are ogling the driver.
I've got
the driver's mate, who's a female.
Oh, see, up until... A woman?
I was almost ready for that.
Well, you would be.
A woman? You said it, sir!
That's right.
If you haven't got that bit in, guards are ogling the pretty driver. You thinking, haven't seen a driver for a long, long time, boy. You look pretty.
Hey, bud, I think that's a woman.
A woman? Anyway.
You said it, sir.
Wouldn't you know it? She shoots him.
She shoots him dead.
There's coffee in the shack.
Later, maybe.
Tell women to your crews.
Don't tell me you're threatened by a woman soldier.
Oh, no way, ma'am. I just like him, is all.
What a nice thing to say.
Hey, what's going on?
Liberation, my friend.
God, lady! All right, just cool it, okay?
Can't trust them.
Yeah, I've got it. Yeah, so She gets out, she had a bit of chit-chat, doesn't she?
Yeah.
She shoots them.
Yeah.
Then they come on too strong.
Yeah.
And I've got it. Laurie opens up, like, Highwayman.
Yeah, yeah. And what's it? A Lotus Esprit jumps out the... No, it's not a Lotus Esprit this time.
No, it's just free bikes.
I've got quad bikes, but actually I noticed they had four wheels.
Yeah.
Well, no, they only had three wheels, so they could be quad bikes.
Mm,
they were
tri-bikes.
Tri-bikes. Tri-bikes.
Yeah. Well, we'll go with tri-bikes. We don't care.
I'm going to call them quad bikes anyway, so that's what I've written in my notes. Yeah. They shoot up the base.
They go around, yeah, shoot everyone. There's a lot of R's going on. Have you noticed? There's a lot of,
He got me.
Acting from Cop Rock, I think, there. Everybody acts in Cop Rock.
Did you know I appeared on the stage? As all the guards, yeah, fall out this way and that way.
Yeah.
And they're shooting oozes and then,
yeah, I've got that, yeah.
Yeah. And then the guard hits a barrel or two, don't they? And we get it's something oozy, leaky out, comes out.
Yeah, I wasn't quite sure what it was supposed to be at that point.
I think it's supposed to be some sort of radiation. Yeah,
acid. I've got acidy, but yeah. Oozy, you know what I mean.
It could have been anything.
It could have been a lot of things.
The secret of the ooze.
Yeah. Yeah, I've got lots of ooze coming in, yeah. And I've got a giant hand. Cool, I don't know what you want to...
Yes.
Hand.
What is this? What could it be? And this is like this is why it's called Resurrection, because the aliens. This is actually a carry-on from the 1950s film.
Yes, yes, as we will mention later. They came from outer space, you know. Still, they came.
They came from Mars, do you say? You know what the chances of something coming from Mars?
Chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one.
Oh, I would have had odds like that.
They come.
Yeah, you would have cleaned up at Ladbrokes.
Someone should write a song about that.
Yeah, I know. I think it would be a great musical theatre experience.
I think it would. I wouldn't talk about it on radio, though.
No.
Scary. Naive people.
They've got...
yeah, we've got a giant hand appears out the barrel.
Yeah, and that's sort of where that bit cuts, isn't it? Then we get the titles.
Yeah, yep.
Then we get a teaching class. And it's a teacher, and it's a load of kids, little kids.
Well, that's usually when you teach.
I know, but this
I know what you mean.
Mathematics and stuff.
Oh, it's high grade mathematics. Yeah.
I thought, these must be geniuses, but no, they're just on a field trip.
Yeah.
Poor sods. I thought we were going to the dinosaur museum.
Didn't it used to be in Fantastic Journey Voyage? Well, something fantastic.
What did you tune in for?
I've got people at this point, because I don't know who. People enter the class. Adults, shall we say.
Adults.
Entered the classroom.
One of them, I think, is the principal.
Yeah.
Or the head of this institute.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if it's a school institute.
I have no idea of this. I don't know if they're being tortured or they're being taught. I think we get...
It gets a great quote. He says, you can learn something about everything, or the man who tries to learn something about everything will learn something about nothing, or...
Go back to your tune.
It went over my head.
We've now got it goes back to a clip of the baddies now, aren't they? They're
back at the
base. They're holding the dump. It's like a dump now, isn't it? Like, now it's the daylight.
Yeah. We're not sure what it is.
And we get a shot of the empty barrel.
Yeah. And I think they're trying to make a bomb or something from the radiation material in this, I think.
Yeah, I know. It was a bit...
Because they're trying to do a satellite link to put their message out to the world.
Yeah. Goes back to the classroom. You got the teachers talking.
You got Susanna is in now.
Well, yeah, but I didn't know their names at this point.
She's a biologist, I think.
Yes.
Microbiologist.
Yeah, well, we'll go with that.
And they're chatting away. She has a daughter, apparently. He gets in there quick.
Yeah.
Ephraim, now that I've got you, whatever happened to my request for a microbiologist?
Have I ever denied you, Harrison? Dr. McCulloch has just joined the Institute. She's yours, if you want her.
Welcome aboard. I gave up hand buzzers years ago.
Assumptions are dangerous things.
Then they meet Norton, don't they? Who's in a wheelchair.
Yes, he's playing an old... The thing is, it is now, but at the time, he was playing an up to the date golf game, wasn't he?
Oh yeah.
But now it's a very, very old golf game.
Yeah. Well, he's back in Tosh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lease sale or something.
He's waiting for the tape to load. Don't breathe. Don't shut that door.
Yeah. Don't touch that volume. No. Oh, no. Back to
God, here we go again. Yeah, crashed.
Then we're back at the base. Oh, sorry, when they were talking to Lorca, there's a lot of sexual innuendos going on.
Yeah.
Because she is a woman, as we know.
A woman?
Suzanne's a woman.
Yes, we have noticed this. And Norton's got, is it like a voice-activated...
Chair.
Wheelchair. Chair.
Yes, yeah. He does, yes.
Because yeah, I didn't realise he was...
No, I did at first. No. He's supposed to be in a wheelchair, but I just thought he was lazy.
Yeah, I did. That's what I thought. How about he's used up all his energy playing the golf game. Yeah. He's waited for 4 days for that thing to load.
He had his golf shoes on, I suppose he didn't want to ruin the carpet.
Well, fair point.
Yeah.
Norton? No, 6 under, 1 to go. Harrison, didn't your parents teach you any manners? Don't you know you're not supposed to interrupt a man when he's standing at the tee?
What happened to Jamaica? No problem, man.
Even in Jamaica, it's only no problem when it's no problem. Who are you?
Suzanne McCullough.
Norton Drake.
Suzanne's the new microbiologist that Ephraim has been promising us.
Oh, too pretty to be a microbiologist. Microbiologists are all nearsighted and losing their hair. Coffee?
No, don't bother.
And miss the chance to show off? Gertrude, back 3. Left 5. Forward 12.
Norton just loves to show off his voice-activated dragster.
Right 45. Got something even better. Been refining the blend for months. One sip and you'll be weeping. You like it black, I hope?
Yes, Norton, I like it black.
She can stay.
So, yeah, he rides around and his voice activates.
And he makes the best coffee.
Oh, apparently so.
One sip of this, he tells that Suzanne, and you'll never want any other coffee. It is that good.
Yeah.
I can't remember what she thought of the coffee.
No.
She didn't review it or anything.
Well.
I think she liked it.
Did she remember what was in the coffee?
No.
Hence the daughter.
No, we're back on the base.
Yeah, we've got a guard, or I don't know whatever you would call him, but he's investigating, he's walking around and he sees the empty barrels.
These are the terrorists, aren't they, now?
He sees the empty barrels.
That's suspicious.
Now we get a technicolour vision of him looking at the barrels, don't we?
Yes, alien perspective, viewpoint now.
Yeah. The head terrorists, they're preparing their demands, aren't they? He's preparing a speech, isn't he?
For the president, yes.
Yeah, this is what he's going to say.
Yeah, blah, Donald, blah, blah. Listen to this. Yeah. We've got some demands. Then we go... I know we've still the aliens.
Yeah.
I've got Menzed is the first one to be attacked because he screams out.
Well, yeah, I've got alien attacks the terrorists.
Are you going to expose me?
Oh, sorry.
Excuse me?
That's what the alien says. Well, more like...
It's very good, this.
I done it on my Yamaha. So the aliens are... taking over.
He needs a Welsh voice in the background there. But yeah, the Italian alien.
Tom Jones.
Yeah, Tom Jones. Not that.
It's not unusual.
No. Aliens have attacked the terrorists, and the rest go.
They're sort of nipping them off one by one, aren't they?
Yeah, and some of the other terrorists have gone out to go find them, haven't they?
Yeah.
And they say the aliens are picking them off one by one.
They take it. I think eventually they get them all. The two head ones, the girl and the leader, are also taken.
Yes, and. What's his name? Mossad, whatever his name was.
Mezed.
Mezed, that'll do. He starts talking gibberish, doesn't he?
He does, yeah.
He's not just Welsh.
I didn't know you were going to say that.
How many come from Wales? 50% are American. How much are Welsh?
They're counted as part of us. I'm sorry.
Never have it. I won't have it.
We're all in it together.
Not having it. You take that back.
Don't worry, after Brexit, they'll be gone.
Tear down dotted line. Detach Wales.
Now we've got, sorry, I've forgotten his name already. Harrison. Harrison and Susanna.
Harrison Ford, yeah.
Harrison and Susanna talking.
Yeah, he tells her about the job.
Yeah. Her job is to daydream.
Yeah, how to dream about, yeah, finding new worlds.
Yeah.
New life, new civilizations. To boldly go where no one has gone. Wales.
Because it's all nice. He wants everyone to think outside the box.
Yeah.
He says, if we don't think in different directions, we can't imagine how life will be out there.
Yeah, because it's explained a bit later why he says these things. Yeah. To me at this moment, I'm thinking he's nuts.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Oh, you hippie, I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Flower power.
Never catch on.
They're the aliens again, aren't we?
Yeah, yeah. They've taken over all the terrorists, but I put it, not sure how.
Yeah,
I don't know how they do it.
No, I don't. How do they get the bodysuits on?
Well, that's what I couldn't work out. Do they
leave their own bodies behind and go inside these? Or no, it's never shown.
Well, not explained. In this episode.
No.
Spoiler. But
they don't know how long they've been asleep for.
No. They obviously now, because they realise they're on American TV, they start speaking in
now, the leader says, language. Speak as they would speak.
Oh, yeah. Gibberish.
So stop the Welsh.
But they need to contact their own planet for help, don't they? That's
they do.
What they're saying. Because at this point, they still don't. It's just planet. No, they come from Mars.
No, these bodies are weak.
Yeah. But it's the best we can find. And
they said, well, we've got to load up all the barrels onto the truck and got to find somewhere else to go.
Yeah.
We can't release any more of our brothers type thing.
Yeah.
We've only got these bodies.
Yeah.
Let's get everyone else on in the barrels on board.
Yeah.
I don't know they take the radiation barrels with them as well. That's what woke them up.
So. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they've got to contact their council. If it's even like our council, there
you go. Well, you've got no
for a long way.
Yeah, you've got to write, you phone them up. Is this... Press 1 if you need help. Yeah. Press 2 if you've crashed your spaceship.
Press 3. Press 3 if your bins have been stolen again.
Press 4 if it's none of the above. Or hold if you want to speak to an operator.
And then we go to that option. You have another load of options.
Oh, yeah. Are you sure you want to speak? Are you sure your bins haven't been stolen?
Have you looked around the shed?
Yeah.
Anyway, Harrison and Susanna.
Yeah, they're chatting, aren't they? And Harrison's a lady turns up.
He tells her, if you're not having a good time, you're doing something wrong.
Yeah.
I'm not judging.
Try the coffee again.
I'm not judging, but their HR department at the university was very busy. Let's just say that.
We got a lady friend turns up to see Harrison. It is a lady friend at this point, because again, this is the point where I'm writing it as I see it. And 2 seconds later, it's explained.
Say what you see. Say what you see.
Exactly. And she's a bit jealous of the late of
Yeah, she
Sudan.
Does. Yeah. She gives a harsh look.
Oh, she does, yeah. Yeah. Mm, get you, girl.
Yeah. Is this your new bit, eh? I think this is his wife who's picking him up. It later emerges.
That she isn't.
No, she isn't. But that's how I could work out if he was just... He had a string of ladies.
Yeah, I couldn't work out.
If this was something permanent, but later it turns out it's a bit more permanent than that.
Meanwhile, the aliens have sent their message. They've held on. They've got to the operator.
Yeah, now they've got to wait.
Yeah.
I told them.
Well, insert more coins.
Yeah, you need to form that format in triplicate.
Yeah, yeah.
No, that's the wrong form.
Sorry, BT Cellnets no longer exists. Upgrade your device.
There's a gala going on.
Yeah, they're going to a
Harrison.
Party. Harrison and the lady friend. They've gone to a party, haven't they?
He's looking a bit bored. He doesn't.
Yeah, he really doesn't.
It's not a party because he's wearing a dinner jacket and everything. It's
not
a posh
his sort of thing.
But she says it's good. It's good for the fundraiser.
Yeah, it's for your profile. Oh, you need to be out there. Yeah. You need to speak to the.
Board members all these rich people who can help you.
Meanwhile, Norton has picked up the aliens broadcast, hasn't he? The message going out.
Yes, he has.
He contacts Harrison to leave the party now, you must come here, I've got some information. And when Harrison gets there, he explains that, you know, for years we've heard these alien strange messages and that. He goes, yeah. He goes, well, so what's different about this one? He goes, this one was emanating from the Earth instead of to the Earth.
It's an outgoing call.
Yeah, it's an outgoing call.
Sleep. I've seen these radio wave patterns before, several times.
You've seen these before. Radio patterns collected from a point in space. I'll give you the coordinates later. Those patterns originated from a broadcast point on Earth.
You're sure?
Of course I'm sure. That's why I yanked you from a party you didn't want to be at. Just notice the parity between the two. Don't even try to figure out the contents, Harrison. Just look at the patterns. That's a signal. That's a response. That's a response to the first response.
And there's a response to the second response. My God. Communication.
On the money.
I can't wait to see what the supercomputer has to say about this. Reserve priority time if you need to.
Oh, now, Wodok, slow down. You are talking megabucks. How are you going to justify that to the penny pinchers?
Norton, the Cray is the best computer in the world. Don't ask me, ask it.
Which costs more.
Yeah, it does, yeah. God. Reverse the charges on that. Oh, my God. Intergalactic money as it is.
It's terrible, terrible. It could be half a shekel, that.
Yeah, intergalactic money against the dollar. It was terrible. Terrible exchange rate.
And Harrison's over the moon. He's happy. There's aliens on Earth. Don't worry about it, people.
Yeah, I mean, his missus is a bit miffed that he's left the ball.
Yeah.
After a phone call, but...
But he's as Harry as lucky as Harry is. ET's phoned home, he's going... Finally.
Now we've got Hangar 15.
Hangar 15.
Oh, yeah. Right, we're on the same hangar.
Yeah. And the ships...
The ships
begin
are there.
...begin to wake. Because these now... Now you get a shot of the original ships...
From the 1950s film.
From the 1950s film.
Yes.
And they're in this... huge hangar, there's the art to cover in the corner there. There's a sign, Warehouse 13 this way. But the ships have started to wake up, haven't they? You got the familiar... If you've ever seen the film, you get the familiar noise. I'm sure someone's got the sound effect.
But I've only got that one. Is that good enough?
No.
Okay, not starting.
But they've started to wake up anyway.
Yes.
And Harrison and... Is it just Harrison? And he goes off to get Susan, isn't he?
He does.
Yeah.
He says field trip time.
Yeah, he goes, don't worry about the missus, or we don't know yet, missus.
Yeah, don't worry about your daughter.
Yeah, you're coming on a field trip with me.
Overnight?
Yeah, yeah. Don't worry about it, love.
Oh, God. Mm.
This will get their tongues wagging.
Yeah, because Norton finds the location.
Yes, he triangulates.
He triangulates. Ooh. You always got to triangulate.
You've got to.
And then we're at the original base. Iron Horse has arrived.
Get me Iron Horse.
As it did.
But the girlfriend's not happy.
Oh, good.
Harrison's going
she's
out.
She's really cross.
Yeah, she's getting, going with that, her, are you? Mm.
This won't be the end of it. Well, actually, he doesn't tell her he's going
to. Harrison's learnt on that one.
What happens at Hangar 15 stays at Hangar 15.
Exactly. And they're driving along, aren't they, as you do in their merry little van. And they come across a police army's
roadblock,
checkpoint, yeah. And they're told they can't go any further. There's nothing to see. Yeah. Nothing to see, moving on.
And Harrison's saying, don't say why we're here.
Yeah, he says, but why can't we? It's a free road, there's nothing to stop me. Why can't we? No, you've got to go back, you've got to turn back.
We've got guns.
We've got guns.
But anyway, Iron Horse shows up.
Get me Iron Horse.
Because they've sort of detained them, haven't they?
Yes. I don't know why.
No, because before it wasn't. There was no clue that we're going to detain them, but they detained them suddenly.
Suddenly, yeah.
But Iron Horse shows up saying they can go. And he goes, but we want to go further. Inwards. He goes, I've got a tape here of all the alien transmissions.
Yes, he tells Iron Horse. He tells them what Harrison has found, doesn't he? All the transmissions and things like that.
They triangulate it to this base and stuff.
Dr. McCullough?
Yes?
Blackwood?
Present. Unaccounted for.
I've checked. You're clear to leave.
But we don't want to leave. We want to wander on down the road apace.
Sorry, that's in the vicinity of a restricted military installation.
But these are public roads.
Presently under military authority. Besides, there's nothing for you to see.
Which explains your reluctance to let us see for ourselves.
We can do this one of two ways. You can turn around and go home, or you can force me to detain you until I've had a chance to re-verify your backgrounds. With the Army, that's been known to take several days. Which is it, Doctors?
Is it, Captain?
Lieutenant Colonel Ironhorse.
Does it make any difference, Colonel, that we both have top secret clearances?
Not to me, it doesn't. Around here, it's need to know, Doctor. And you don't need to know. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Aren't you the slightest bit curious as to what may have brought us out here in the first place?
Officially, I can't ask.
Last night, one of my associates intercepted some radio transmissions originating from this location.
What kind of transmissions?
For the moment, let's just say that they were highly unusual.
You wouldn't happen to have a copy of these unusual transmissions?
Is this the beginning of a negotiation, Colonel?
Now we go back to the aliens, and they're... Well, they haven't used Factor 15, have they? Let's be honest. They're deteriorating.
They're not looking so sharp now.
No, they're not looking peachy, are they? This is what happens when you use these oil of UV stuff. It just doesn't work. It doesn't work with the aliens.
There's six of them, apparently.
Yeah.
And there should be thousands in the barrels. Oh, that's what they're saying about at the base. He says, oh, there were six barrels that are open.
Yeah.
But there were thousands of these barrels here. Where have they gone?
Yeah.
Because they're the barrels they loaded on the truck in the sector there.
This is the... At this point, it's like... I didn't get this. I think they're a bit further on as well.
Yeah.
Because they're just barrels. There's no seams. They're just... In a field, aren't they? They're not exactly overly protected.
No, when an alien dies, you stick them in a barrel. Everyone knows that.
Well, yeah, you kind of think we'll put them in the hangar, at least. But they're just sat in the field, aren't they?
Yeah, outside in the field.
So now you're sort of thinking, hold on.
I think what probably happened is they were in a secure location. Then they think, I want to put my new Jeep in here. Barrels, let's just roll them out into the car park.
Roll out the barrel?
Oh, yeah. We'll have a barrel of fun.
Oh, well, I can see where it's going.
No one else is there.
Somehow, I'm quite sure now, but Harrison's now at this dump, isn't he?
Because it's because Iron Horse.
Ironside.
It's the wheelchair.
Freudian slip there.
Iron Horse knows that Harrison knows something.
Yeah.
And he's not happy. So now he takes him to the base, doesn't he?
Yeah, and they see all the empty barrels and he's not happy about it.
No, because now it's Harrison's turn not to be happy.
Yes.
Because he says... We need to leave now, damn it, now, he says. Because he suddenly changes, he's all nice and polite.
Yeah, now.
And suddenly he's in there.
He's like that, he goes like that on these field trips. Yeah. She doesn't know what he's like. Now we've got a
couple of drunks. I think one of them was drunk.
Yeah, I put two, one of them wasn't.
Yeah, one of them was just helping the other one to his car. Because like you do, if your mate's drunk, you help him to your car.
Oh yeah, you got to put him in the car, haven't you?
Here's your keys. Do you want me to start the ignition for you?
Yeah, and we're only in a petrol station, so what's going to possibly go wrong?
It was the 80s, it was fine. Smoke some coke while you do that. Yeah.
Have a fag. Shall I light it up here with a naked flame? Yeah, don't worry about that.
You can use your mobile. Oh, no, we haven't invented them yet.
Yeah, so they're at this petrol station, aren't they? And
the truck turns up.
Yeah, the aliens, the truck turns up. They're filling up with gas. That's for you Americans there, people.
No, the guy at the pumps is saying...
He says, I'll do that. Don't worry, I'll do that.
No need for you to do that.
And...
text the past. And he says, oh, we've got a bit sunburnt there.
Yeah. You've been using all of you, like, haven't you?
I think you want a stronger factor. Because, of course, they're peeling from the radiation.
Yeah, and presumably, another alien from around the back, doesn't he, sort of grabs him.
Yes.
His drunk mate, who's in the car,
sees
this happen.
Yeah.
And then...
We've got an eyewitness.
We get a flashback to the movies. Yeah, suddenly the movie's now in it.
Yeah. And we see Harrison Blackwell as a boy, witnessing these aliens.
Yes.
Yeah, then we're back. Then we're back in the room.
This is why he explains why he always thinks outside the box. He knows aliens. This was another point I came up with later, so I shall save this.
Yeah, I think we've got the same point coming up, though.
But Harrison, yeah, so now we know why Harrison says think out of the box.
Yeah.
Because he witnessed in 1956.
Or he knows it's true.
Yeah, that the aliens appeared and all this. And his father was killed.
His parents, I think.
Oh, his family, yeah, well.
And then he went to stay with the doctor, who was the main doctor in the film.
Yes. And it drove him nuts, didn't it, apparently?
Yes, all he did was write and go on about the aliens all the time.
Yeah.
Day and night. But now Susanna's quitting.
Yes, she goes, this is what I signed up for. Yeah. You dragged me out here in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. You haven't even tried it on yet. Yeah. You know, the daughter's at home. three cups of coffee, nothing.
I don't get out very often. And this is what I get, nothing.
Yeah, nothing.
You've not even looked at me. You've looked at Iron Horse more than you've looked at me.
Iron Horse, when he was rather dashed.
Oh, I've looked at Iron Horse a few times.
In his army uniform, though.
What a guy. Do you know he was in Predator?
Was he?
Yeah. He's fighting them aliens all the time. Oh, Iron Horse. Yeah. Can't get good that man down.
No, you show me an alien and Iron Horse is there. Anyway, yeah, she wants to go home.
Harrison tries to tell her about the aliens.
Possible invasion.
About 1950.
Yeah.
The War of the Worlds.
Yeah, yeah.
And how the bacteria stopped them at the time.
Yeah.
But it didn't kill them. It just sent them to sleep. And the professor he was staying with, after his parents died, he thought that as well back then. He wrote whole papers about it. Now,
I've got in brackets here, he seems to be the only person that remembers this invasion.
Absolutely, this is what I've got. And I was thinking, did it happen? It did happen. So how come he's the only one who knows about it? Surely it would have been...
It was all over the world. They were attacking everywhere. Apparently, only in America.
It's not called, like, War of Io.
No.
It's called War of the World.
Yeah.
The whole world was involved.
And I remember the film, and it showed you them attacking everywhere.
Do you think they've got the history books? I'm thinking, should we mention this War of the World things in the history? It's all right. Yeah. Everyone knows. There's no putting it in there.
Yeah. Anyway, who won the World Cup in 1966?
It's really weird, because everyone should know about it.
Oh, no, especially the army. It's kind of worrying when the army doesn't know anything about this.
But I thought, you either go one of two ways. You go, oh, it was just a hallucination, it didn't really happen.
No.
Mass hallucination. Or you embrace it totally and say, yes, it's real. Oh, yes, I remember that. That was a terrible...
Because... The other point is, they're all the same age,
yes,
roughly. Yes. It's not as though Harrison is like 30 years older than these people. No. They're all roughly the same age.
Yeah.
And you're thinking, she's a microbiologist. Surely she's heard about the alien invasion and investigated about...
Well, there'd be nothing but studies and studies on it, wouldn't there?
You'd think so.
Autopsy after all, alien autopsy.
No.
And then the barrels full of them.
Apparently, no one knew.
So have they covered it? Do you think it was the men in black? They were their little thing. Just look into the red light. Look into the red light, everyone.
At that moment, Harrison looked away and that was it.
He blinked.
Always blinks when the camera goes. Yeah. Hold on, my shoelace is undone. What's happened?
I couldn't get my head around.
What, no, I couldn't.
Either go with it or don't go with it. Just don't go in between.
He's the only one that remembers.
No one else will admit to it.
No. Let's be fair.
Yeah.
A bit later on.
Okay.
But at this point, no one remembers the invasion. Nobody.
What invasion? I mean, I remember the loud noises and woke me up from my sleep, but I just turned over. What? But aliens, Christ, Cole crashed in the roads. What are you on about?
No.
I must have slept in that day.
There was nothing on the news. I went to see the latest Donald Duck movie, I'll tell you, and there was nothing there.
Well, I thought the bus was late because of the road traffic, but...
I just thought it was a crazy LP released by some British person.
No, it was Orson Welles who did it. It wasn't true.
Anyway,
the drunk tells the cops.
Yes.
That what he saw. He thought these bad guys had a gorilla with them.
That's right, yeah. He says it was a gorilla.
They don't like the monkeys, do they?
I've told you. How many times have I told you about these monkeys? You can't trust them.
No.
You cannot trust them.
But they can
I've seen the documentary. Apparently, I'm the only one that's seen the documentary about these monkeys.
Guerrilla warfare. He says, I think these are involved in guerrilla warfare, but I didn't know they'd have a real guerrilla with them. That's it.
Very literal.
I wonder why I wrote guerrilla there. What? Oh, yeah, guerrilla warfare.
Well, now the army have turned up.
Yeah.
Because at this point, yeah, it's just the cops, isn't it? And now the army turn up and they've detected radiation.
Iron Horse. Iron Horse is there. He's everywhere.
They seek him here, they seek him there. Iron Horse is everywhere. Apparently, but not when the aliens invaded in
1950. Yeah, we were a couple of weeks off.
Right, fair play.
How'd you ever get elected asking dumb questions like that?
Good morning, Sheriff.
Sheriff Deke. What's the army doing out this way?
Colonel! They've been through here for sure.
Scout the area, Sergeant.
All right, set it up.
We had an incident involving suspected terrorists. There's a good chance they've been through this area.
Terrorists? Oh, damn, I knew it! Didn't I tell you, Sheriff? I've been reading about this here guerrilla warfare. Only thing is, I didn't know that those terrorists use real guerrillas.
And we've got Dr. Foster, who...
Went to Gloucester.
That's who Harrison stayed with.
Yeah.
That's who raised him.
Yeah, yeah. Harrison explains how he became to be where he is.
I didn't believe the aliens were dead. And then this Suzanne, the microbiologist, she goes on about the African lungfish can be out of water for
12 years or something.
Yeah.
And a drop of water
will come back to life. Maybe that's like here.
Yeah, she's quick to now believe about the alien story, considering she knew nothing about them beforehand.
Yeah. Then she tears up her resignation letter. She's back in.
Yeah, she's back in. Now, we've got the back to the steel drums that I've got look kind of plastic to me.
All right.
Yeah.
But so Harrison goes back home and his wife, girlfriend, lady, she's not happy. She's thrown all his clothes out into the lawn and everything.
She's his girlfriend, isn't it?
Yeah.
Or his fiance.
Yeah. And then at Pentagon with the general.
He's going to go off to DC, isn't he? Now he's at the Pentagon.
And this just so happens to be, this is Susanna's uncle.
Yes.
Is the general.
Now, he does remember the alien invasion.
35 years ago, they tried to take over the world.
Yeah.
But we need proof.
No, he remembers it.
Yeah, he remembers it.
He's the only other person in the entire world that remembers it.
We've only got two so far.
Yeah. You think he might have let a few others in on it.
Yeah.
But yeah, he wants proof, doesn't he? You've got to give me proof, he says. If you can give me proof, I'll go higher.
Yeah, it's something about the radiation is killing the bacteria, and that's why the aliens are coming back.
Yeah. That's what they think, isn't it?
Fantastic story I think I've ever heard. That's no story. That's scientific theory supported by fact presented in a logical and reasonable fashion. I'm a respected astrophysicist. I'm not some kook spouting UFO stories.
Oh, I don't mean to suggest otherwise, Doctor. That you were brought here by my niece gives you more credibility than I think you realize.
Niece, you told me that he was your father's friend.
Uncle Hank is my father's favorite brother.
And you're my favorite niece. Unfortunately, Doctor, I'll need some hard evidence before I can act on your theory. Now, this morning I read a report based on the incident you make reference to, which suggests the work of a terrorist group. What the hell are they called? Oh, yes, the People's Liberation Party.
General, I'm trying to warn you about something a lot more insidious than terrorists.
Why don't you try to look at it from my point of view?
You don't have a point of view. 35 years ago, these things tried to take over the world. They're completely ruthless with absolutely no sense of mercy. My God, they killed my parents.
I'm truly sorry, Doctor. You bring me something concrete, and I'll give you my word. I'll see to it that it gets to the right people.
Now, for some reason, the aliens are burning down the house. Yeah. I don't know why. It just seemed to be...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there's a house on fire. I don't know why. It just... Looks good at night, I think. That's the word I can say. Harrison wants to talk to his girlfriend to try and explain. Yeah, she meant nothing to him. Cross. It was a field trip. You know what I'm like on field trips?
I didn't take my Ritmol with me. No. It wasn't anything.
You know what I'm like.
Yeah. But no, she's not buying any of it, is she?
Norton tells him that he's tracked another transmission.
He has.
The aliens have tried to redial.
Yeah. And now,
I'm sorry, your number cannot be reconnected.
And now Harrison's, let's get the chopper. Apparently they've got a chopper.
Well. At which point Susanna's like, oh, okay.
This is some user versus. The stealth jet was busy.
Yeah. I've got it. Is it two hunters?
Yes.
Find the aliens, don't they? Find them and they tell the cops and the army, don't they?
Yes.
That they found them burning down the house.
Their house. The report to the police. Iron Horse is there, because he's everywhere.
He's there.
Because Iron Horse wants to move in.
Yes. Now, it turns out, I thought it's an old tourist attraction.
Apparently.
At what point we knew this, I've no idea. No. But we're now told that they're on some old tourist attraction, like Disney World or something.
Yeah. And then we've got Harrison and Susanna are there and spying on them.
Yeah, they're going to spy on the camp, yeah.
They're waiting until dark or something.
Yeah, he said, well, I'm going to get some sleep. And he can sleep instantly.
Anywhere.
Anywhere and instantly.
He says, yeah, if I don't get 1 hour out of 5 hours sleep, I'm useless.
Yeah.
Like he doesn't fly planes or anything.
Only a school teacher, it doesn't make much difference. Or fly in the copter. Yeah. It's got dark now. Because time goes quickly, and they're going to go in. They're going to see what's happening, aren't they?
Yeah, she's going to record it or something, isn't she?
Yeah, and they're just about to, and the army catch them, don't they?
Yes, Iron Horse is there.
He's everywhere. Go on, Iron.
And he's going to send the team in.
He's going to send Delta Force.
HB's saying, no, you don't know what you're dealing with. These aren't normal terrorists.
Yeah, you weren't alive, apparently.
You don't remember this. And no one's ever written it in history books, no. But the aliens attacked.
No army's ever been prepared for it since. Go ask the general.
Maybe you've got someone who's got a cold. Maybe send them in first.
Yeah. They go in, they buy more barrels, don't they?
Yeah,
there's more barrels.
They're not home, I think.
Yes.
So they think.
Yeah. But the aliens start to...
They're in the rafters, they're everywhere.
Yeah, there's pans.
Remember, Iron Horse is special forces, and these are special forces soldiers.
Oh, yeah.
But they don't check all the points in the room. That's all I'm saying.
No, they just walk straight in, don't they? Yeah. Anyone home?
It looks empty. That's what my training's told me.
Yeah. Taken out, yeah. Colonel Iron Horse, he's not happy about him. Now, I've got to see, it's good to see a good old-fashioned bullet kills an alien.
It does, it melts them.
A good old-fashioned bullet. Like, you can't beat it, can you?
Oh, but, yeah, because the aliens don't just have guns.
No.
They have...
Like bolas.
But bolas, yeah.
Yeah, that was it, yeah, they just throw these...
That's non-lethal. Where did they get them from?
I've no idea.
They just make them.
I've no idea.
The Martian weapon of superiority.
Yeah, bonus.
Bonus. That's showing their birth, man. They won't have seen this like before.
Oh, unless they've been to South America. I told you, I went there on my holidays. I liked it. Brought it back to the world. Harrison goes in and he rescues the colonel, doesn't he? But when the
Iron Horse, come on, use his name. No, it's just colonel.
Susanna's gone.
She's gone.
Gone.
Disappeared.
Oh, I don't know. She's gone home.
And he's not happy, Harrison.
No,
I was in with a chance. Yeah. I know it.
Iron Horse wants to leave.
But he says no. Not without her.
No, no. I brought her out here. I've got to take her back.
Yeah,
I've got a deposit to collect.
Just worth 25 cents in return value alone.
Suddenly, daylight appears. And Harrison goes looking for Susanna with Iron Horse.
Yeah.
I can't find her. But she's in the back of the car.
She's in a trunk.
She's assumed the position. I thought you were going to kidnap me. She's going.
I've been waiting all night. I've just got in the trunk myself. Desperation.
I'll tell you, I'm never going on another field trip again with you.
You spent more time with this Iron Horse.
You've not looked at me once.
Susanna gets a sample of the melted alien.
Yes.
In a little tub.
What else would you have? You've always got a little ice cream tub, isn't it? Sort of.
Yeah. Now we're back with the general, who's with Susanna and Harrison.
But Inors doesn't believe they're aliens.
No.
Where does it say in the Army Manual 1950s?
Aliens. Oh, my manual starts in 1960.
Yeah.
It's stuff we're dealing with here, Blackwood. Bolas. Terrorists that don't act like terrorists. Terrorists that don't die like terrorists. I actually saw a body dissolve after I shot it.
We all saw some fairly extraordinary phenomenon, Colonel.
When in God's name is somebody going to start explaining things to me?
I've already explained as much of it as I understand myself.
You've explained nothing, mister. I don't believe in ghosts, and I sure as hell don't believe in aliens from another planet.
Excuse me for sounding uptight, but can we argue about this someplace else?
And, I was going to say, Inors doesn't believe in aliens. It's as though the film never happened.
Yeah, it really is. Then we get, the general saying we're going to set up a top secret,
yes,
team.
Oh, secret.
Yeah.
So secret that even I don't know it's a secret.
It's going to be Harrison, Susanna, Norton.
And Inors. Yep.
And money, no object.
Apparently not.
Unlimited funding.
Yep. You got your own chopper already, so we don't need to supply that.
Would you like two? How about one each? One with a ramp.
Now, everyone has to relocate for their safety, yeah?
Yes, that's right.
To a cottage.
Yes, and well, cottage you say.
I know, but it is America.
Yeah.
To us, that's a stately mansion. But to you, it was a cottage.
With acres and acres of hand.
And a horse.
Yeah. Because Susanna's travelling there with her daughter.
Yeah.
And her daughter says, I don't want to leave all my friends. I don't want to. They've got horses.
Yeah.
Sod the friends.
Yeah. Oh, let me terminate my notes. Where have I gone?
You're still here.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Now they meet the housekeeper.
Yes.
I'll come back to that in a bit. They meet the housekeeper.
Oh, the aliens, they've got their own new base as well.
Now the Nevada desert. Yeah,
it's an old nuclear test site.
Yeah, abandoned underground nuclear test site. And the aliens all gather around and go into some sort of trance.
There's three of them, there's always three, you know.
That comes up, doesn't it? Yeah, because Harrison mentions that later. Yeah. It's all three, their hands have got three. Each ship was in freeze. The bolas has got free.
It's like Charmed. Well, the spell of free.
Free is one, wasn't it? Or power of free.
We'll set you free. Power of free. We'll set you free.
Don't say too many times.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, cool. Any demons will be worried now.
Well, the neighbours are, anyway. Anyway, they go into some sort of trance, don't they?
Yes.
And I don't know what they're doing.
Now, Norton has a supercomputer.
Now
it's like a whole room worth of this computer.
Yeah, now we can play Super Golf.
In 8 megapixels.
Yeah. And Susanna has a new lab to find new bacteria. Obviously, that's what you go looking for.
And Harrison has his office completely remade in this, exactly, down to the last detail.
Well, yeah. How did they know what was in the drawers? That's what got me.
I just took the desk.
we've copied your office from home, and you've even got everything that was in the drawers. Have you still got my... you have.
Wait a minute. Isn't this my desk? No, we're recreating it. Cost no expense spared.
And... Iron Horse tells the daughter, Susanna's daughter, that his ancestors used to be shaman.
That's right.
Apparently now it's revealed that Iron Horse was an Indian of some.
Well, I think you could gather that from the name.
Well, I possibly not know.
All right.
Could be anything. And they had old drawings of spacemen, didn't they?
No one
believed them. They thought he was on the Raz.
They thought he was drinking too much.
Yeah. Smoking that pipe again, are you?
No one listened to the shaman.
Now, Now, the housekeeper and her husband ask if they're staying long.
Yeah.
This is a government facility, isn't it? Yeah. A top secret government facility. And they're like, well, you're staying long.
Yeah.
We've only got one loaf in. Because he says that. I've got to get some more bread. You think, how secret's this? They don't even know.
Well, I took this safe house job because I thought no one would use it.
It's so secret, they don't even know it's a safe house.
Crap in my style now. I used to walk around in my underwear.
No. Okay, so...
You'll be here long?
Well, we hope not, Mr. Kensington. I mean, no offense, man.
None taken, Dr. Blackwood. You stay here as long as you have to. Now, what sort of a question was that?
We might have to restock the pantry.
I take care of the pantry. The grounds is your job.
I guess I better check the security system and turn in. Good night, all.
Colonel, you really believe that story?
Indian folklore, Mr. Drake. Nothing more, nothing less.
Funny thing about folklore, almost always there's an element of truth in it.
Even the safe house people don't know it's a safe house.
They don't like
it. We've never been in the basement.
We don't like people.
No, that's why we moved here.
Are you local people? No, I thought it was a little bizarre.
Yeah. Now the aliens, they're waiting for the ships.
They are.
They're waiting for the ships to contact them,
wait till
to wake up.
Strong again.
Yeah. And this is where Harrison tells about the number three being significant aliens. Yeah, he says about the power of three will set you free.
Yeah, because Norton needs more information.
Yeah, and he's...
The number three means something to the aliens.
Yeah, and this is where Harrison says, look for the third star on the left.
Now, Susanna's found something in her lab.
It was a microscope. it was the old boy from upstairs staring at her. What are you doing here? This is where we keep the milk.
She found out that the aliens are half alien, half human now.
Wow.
Hybrid.
Mm.
Norton has found something, how to crack the alien code, base 3. Because the number 3, and it's in our base 3, and he's cracked the code.
Yeah.
And they found out what the aliens are hunting for. And Harrison tells Ironside...
When he says about his base, he says it in a really bad Jamaican accent.
He does.
Suddenly he's Jamaican.
I don't know.
He's obviously got a Bob Marley LP on the background. 8-track.
And Harrison tells Iron Horse, the thing is, the Area 51 is a hoax.
Yeah.
It's Hangar 15, that's where we need to go.
Oh, no, he said, they run the computer program, it says that they're going to attack an Air Force base. And Harrison tries to think like an alien and a soldier, doesn't he?
Yes.
And he says about Hangar 18.
Oh, that's it, Hangar 18.
It's disinformation. 18 doesn't exist. It's all at Hangar 15, as we know, because we saw it earlier.
Yeah.
Have you ever heard of Hangar 15?
No.
The place where stores all its UFO evidence.
You mean Hangar 18? Or Building 18 at Wright-Patterson? Forget it, Doctor. That's all a myth.
No. Hangar 18 is the myth. That's disinformation created by the military. Hangar 15, that's the real McCoy.
I don't believe it.
Dr. Forster did, it's in his papers. I think now might be the time to call General Wilson. Ask him if it's a myth.
Because Iron Horse says, no, it's at 18. He goes, no, it's not at 18, it's 15.
I've got two drunk soldiers leaving the bar.
Yes.
And they're from the Hangar 15, I think.
Yep.
And then the aliens...
Take them over. Yeah. Grab them. Catch those soldiers.
Oh, these are Air Force guys.
Yeah.
Because then the aliens need a chopper to get into the base, apparently.
Harrison has now convinced Ironhorse side.
You almost did it.
Michael Ironside, or whatever his name.
Buckle Ironhorse.
Yeah. That the aliens are going after the ships.
Yes. So we've got to get there first.
Yeah, we've got to get to Hangar 15, 13, whatever.
Yeah.
Now at the airbase, the aliens... they've now got a helicopter assault force, haven't they?
Yeah. Well, because they've got all these SAS, you know, special forces guys now.
Yes, because they've taken them over, haven't they? Now they're ready.
The trio, isn't it? Iron Horse, Harrison, and Susanna.
Yeah.
They go to the base first. They get there first. Yeah. And they tell them this is just an exercise.
Yeah.
Is that because they can't tell them what's going on at the base for some reason?
What? Yeah, I've got it. Yeah, and they turn up at Hangar 15. There's nobody there.
No, it's empty. Yeah. The door's not even locked.
No.
It's on the latch.
Pretty much. Yeah. No one tells them how to open the door.
There's a code, isn't there? There's a code.
And I've got it. But you'd have thought they would have already had the code.
Yeah.
Because they would have just phoned the colonel up and go, we're going to Hangar 15. Yeah, give us the door code.
Yeah. It's too secret.
Yeah.
It's above my pay grade. Donald knows that code. It's a great code. It's a super code.
Is it free?
It's going to be the best code in the world.
Is it 333?
Yeah.
Is it 1, 2, 3?
4.
Or is it 0, 0, 0, 0? But they go in and they find there's loads of crates.
Yes.
Like I say, the Ark of the Covenant and all these crates are sitting there.
Oh, Harrison. Won't take a gun.
Yeah, no. Oh, no, he doesn't believe in guns.
Doesn't believe in guns?
No.
It's right in front of you.
No one else believes in aliens, but I don't believe in guns.
They were never invented.
There was a quick glimpse. I may have got this wrong.
Yeah. But
there was a quick glimpse when they're walking through past these crates. There's more alien aircraft, different alien aircraft.
Was there? Oh,
I'm sure there is.
There could have been.
It might have been. It may have been. It was a different angle of the... original three,
yeah.
But I'm sure there was different alien aircraft in there.
That's right.
And they walk past. Okay, there's no security.
No one there.
No one knows Hangar 15 exists.
Not even a camera in there.
And they decide they're going to plant bombs on the ships, aren't they?
Yeah.
Harrison, Susanna, and Ironhorse. They're going to plant bombs all over these ships. Yeah.
And they've got the aliens arriving there.
Yeah, they turn up in their helicopter.
There's a 10-minute... They've got 10 minutes to get out now before the bombs go off.
Yeah. And the aliens will start attacking the base. I don't know why, because there's no bugger there.
No, Arnold says, these are my men, though. And Harrison saying, no, they're not anymore. You've lost them.
Yeah.
They start to run, don't they?
Yeah, I've got here, chemicals start to kill the aliens. Chemicals kill the aliens, so do bullets.
Oh, yes, because Susanna's invented a chemical to spray on the aliens.
Oh, yeah.
She carries this backpack thing, this chemical, with her.
As you would.
And she sprays the alien, but it doesn't kill him. It knocks him back.
Yeah.
But then he starts to get up again.
Yeah, so they shoot him.
Shoot him, yeah, that works.
Bullets always work.
That works better.
I don't know why he brought that.
No, they have to run out, don't
they? The ship's now starting to wake up, aren't they?
Because the aliens are now inside them, they're getting inside the ship.
Yeah, and
they blast the hole on the roof.
They're getting more woken up. They've got familiar sounds.
And for some reason, they start chasing the trio now.
Yeah.
Blowing up everything in their path.
I've got it. Ships start to chase them.
Yeah.
Very poor shot.
Yeah, blast through the roof, shooting at the trio.
They can't hit three humans.
And they're looking at the timer, and it says, it's not going off. Where's the explosion?
Yeah.
Where's the kaboom? There was supposed to be an earth-shattering kaboom.
Oh, that's the best one you've had. Good old Marvin.
But there's a delay.
Yeah.
But suddenly the ships do blow up.
They start to blow up, yeah. Oh, that was nerve-wracking. I didn't think they were going to get through it.
No, I was really worried for them.
Yeah.
They were killed in the first episode. It would have been tragic. Back at the base.
They're all happy. Yeah. They're all happy. Apart from the old couple who are saying, you still here? I thought you'd gone.
Yeah, because they're saying, oh, I'm glad it's all behind us.
Yeah.
And Harrison says, but is it?
Yeah, government, explain it all away. Is it all over?
General Wilson is taking care of the Joint Forces Board of Inquiry. I'm told that, unofficially, of course, the board is predisposed to lay the blame on an unnamed terrorist organization.
Whole lot closer to the truth than they'll ever realize.
I'm just glad all of this is behind us.
Is it? Is it really?
But three aliens are still behind at the...
Yeah, the trio of aliens, the main, like, the gal, the guy, and Mendez, maybe?
Muzrat.
Whatever he was.
They're still there. Alive. They're still there, still trancing.
And they're surrounded by the barrels, of course.
Yeah,
right. And there's an alien on the keyboard typing as well.
Yes.
Damn QWERTY keyboard, how am I supposed to use that?
Always keep a secondary alien.
Our council allows us no margin for failure.
Primitives have proven to be unexpectedly clever.
Their cleverness will not save them. We will improvise.
As long as we meet the deadline.
And that was it.
That was the long first episode.
I didn't think they'd make it.
That was it. So, well, that was quite a journey, wasn't it?
It was. Luckily, we now believe Harrison, because no bugger else did.
That's right.
I can't get over
that. I thought he was straight up telling the truth right away.
Well, I knew he was. I knew he was that kind of guy.
I might have not been around in the 50s, but, you know, I've seen the historical documents.
Now, my only fun fact was they ended season 2 after 14 episodes.
Yes.
But they actually filmed the further 6.
Yeah.
And it gave them a chance to actually finish it all.
Ah.
They actually concluded the whole season, the whole story.
Sorry, yeah.
It gets more fun. Did you read?
I didn't actually.
Oh, well... More aliens turn up, because the aliens don't get on with another bunch of aliens, apparently.
Never do.
They never do.
No.
They never do.
There's always trouble.
And I'm sure they Harrison and that contact this other lot, and they turn up. Yeah. It's an alien party.
It is. So where are these aliens from?
Oh.
Venus?
Lord knows. But anyway.
Anyhow. Well, I've got a couple of things.
I'll go for it then.
Anne Robinson, not that one.
Oh, points of view.
you're not the weakest link.
Oh.
She played...
You are the weakest alien. Goodbye.
She played Sylvia Van Brunn in the original film. She also comes back into this series a couple of times.
How? Because, no, it didn't happen. No one knows it happened.
She was in 3 episodes. I've got the episodes. The Naked Monster...
Well, that, I think that's Harrison going on another field trip again, isn't it?
I'm sorry, no, these were films you were in. I just loved the title of this film. It was The Naked Monster, Man Dinosaur. So she's done some stellar work. Yeah, she was in 3 episodes, though. So.
But apparently no, not the film.
Not the film.
Not the film.
She was in Tom Cruise's film as well. Playing the same character.
Oh, was she?
Yes.
Oh.
The 2005 film.
Yeah, which I don't remember a lot about.
No, I don't either. I know it wasn't that great.
No, it's more visually pleasing, I suppose. But I did like the original movie. I can't deny
that. Oh, yeah, it's a great movie, even though it's set in America. And not in Britain.
Not where the books say.
Forever Autumn, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Justin Hayward, hey?
I was looking... Because there was a review I read about it. A review, you say?
A review? Someone else has reviewed this?
Yeah,
how could they possibly review this?
On IMDb, I can't find it now. I know I should have printed it out.
Why would they possibly review this?
They gave it, like, 10 out of 10.
No.
Then all they went on about was how Iron Horse's uniform was wrong for Special Forces. How his badges were in the wrong places, the wrong badges.
That's all they found wrong with it?
That's all they found wrong with it.
Okie dokie.
Apart from that, it's 10 out of 10.
The part that the fact that nobody remembers the aliens ever existed.
You know, I think there's going to be a remake though this year. Because when I was searching for War of the Worlds TV show, it says the 1988.
No, don't make another one.
Will this follow on from Tom Cruise's movie?
I can't remember how that one finished.
No, I don't know. We won the game, I think.
Probably.
Tom Cruise won.
It kind of loses it for me, I'll give it that.
It was hard, wasn't it?
It's hard work, isn't it? The fact that no one, sorry, keep going on about it, but the fact that no one believes that they were ever there in the first place.
No, it's just him and the general.
Yeah.
They're the only ones who know about these aliens.
Apparently so. Because there was no one at Hangar 15, so no one knew that.
No, they didn't know what was kept in there.
They didn't know what was there.
Flying saucer? No.
I think so. Three of them? No.
There was never three flying saucers. A trio of them? So it all sounds familiar.
No. I don't think so. But, yeah.
But it was an hour and a half watch that for us, which is pretty long for us.
It is a very long one. It's very long.
I know. It's sort of usually set into two parts.
Yeah. Yeah. I can't think of what else to say about it.
Not really. It was a long haul.
It's not as good as the original movie.
No.
It's better because it's obviously they can do visual effects. It's nice that they hark back and actually use the original spaceships.
Oh yeah, it was, yeah.
The original. And they used the original sound effects as well.
Yes, they did indeed.
But other than that, it's
nice for them to continue from the film.
It's kind of the invasion.
Yeah.
The TV program, isn't it?
Yeah, yes.
Invaders.
Now, I remember watching this, like, late night.
I remember watching this, I think, one episode.
Yeah, I've watched a few, I think. Because it's quite a dark series. And then you did get main characters being killed off. Iron Horse gets killed off.
No.
Yeah, Iron Horse.
There's only one man that can replace him. Rambo. Get me Rambo.
He's no Iron Horse, though.
Well,
I think it was all right to kill off the main character. I'm not sure if any more.
When you say kill off the main character, is it because they couldn't be bothered to do anything more?
It could be that.
We don't want to be associated with this. Did you know I'm going to be in a film called Predator? Or have I been already? I'm not sure.
Predator, when was that? It's 87, do you
is
think?
It? I can't remember.
Was it before?
Probably.
I think it might have been.
Probably. It didn't happen either.
Yeah, so, oh no, you got Harrison was in 43 episodes. Susan was in 43 episodes.
And the boot of the car.
Norton Drake was 24.
Don't sound good for Norton, does it?
Oh, I think he did get killed off. Oh. And there we go. Colonel Paul Iron Horse. 24 episodes. So that must have been just the first season.
Him and Norton wanted to go together. It was a beautiful trip. They jumped off. They were like lemmings. They leapt off a cliff together. They'll never separate us.
Do you know who came into it later? You may not know him. It's Adrian Paul of Highlander fame. He was in the second season, so obviously he replaced him one of the others. He got killed off.
Iron Horse 2.
Iron Horse, yeah. Would you like to score this particular show?
It weren't great, was it? It's long. It's very long. It gets the premise going, but it takes a long time to get the premise going.
I felt there was a lot of fat in this two-parter.
Yeah.
Two-parters. That you could really trim quite a lot of this.
They could have. I suppose they wanted to make sure that everyone understood where it was all coming from.
Yeah, and the premise. And
but it seems, as I keep saying, left out bits that nobody knew the aliens ever existed.
Yes.
Nobody.
That was weird.
No matter how old they are, no one remembers them.
Because Suzanne knew nothing.
No, nothing. As a microbiologist, considering at the time they felt that the aliens died from catching the common cold.
Yeah.
You would have felt most microbiologists would have heard about these aliens that died from catching a cold.
What research?
And the fact that they attacked everywhere over the world at the same time.
Yeah.
As all aliens do, I've noticed that in most.
That's
films.
Good. Mostly America they attack, but.
Yeah, pretty much mostly. But there is reports that they're attacking other places all over the world. Yeah.
What would you score this out of a 10 ratio?
Five.
Five?
Yeah, it was. It was middling just long. Yeah,
it was middling. Yeah, I'm giving it a 5 as well. I think they could have tightened it up quite a bit. There were some bits you didn't need.
No.
And although I didn't dislike like Harrison.
He
was a bit too...
Oh, he knows everything.
Laid back, weren't he?
He's laid stuff. Back and he knows Harrison, absolutely everything to know about everything. Yes. Yeah.
Unfortunately, Gerard Martin's no longer with us as well.
No.
It was last year he died, I think.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, maybe last year. I'm not sure what his best remembered for.
Fantastic Voyage in my...
That's what we would remember him best for, but yeah.
What was the other... What else was it we watched and he appeared?
Was it Logan's Run?
It's Logan's Run, yeah. He appears in that, doesn't he?
Is he a Sandman, isn't he, I think?
Is he a Sandman? We'd have to re-review that one. But he does appear, doesn't he?
He's definitely in it, yeah.
Yeah, he is in it.
So it's Michael Biehn.
Is he?
From the Terminator. He's in it as well. You get one shot of him on the radio. But he's in it.
I can see where they're going with it. But there's so many... they're just trying to rehash, aren't they? It's a good story. The film was good.
Yeah, they could use a lot of clips from the film.
Which never happened.
And that's the only time you see about his childhood as well. It's never mentioned again.
Oh. So, I was going to say, you feeling that there must be more alien ships somewhere?
Yeah, because they attacked the world.
Yes.
But they only had 3 in this hangar.
They've now destroyed those 3. The 3 are still in the room chanting and obviously contacting wherever they contacted, because they don't mention it's Mars.
Yeah. Power 3 will set us free. Yeah.
So you know that more ships are going to turn up.
Oh, it's got to be, yeah. Because obviously just 3 aliens aren't going to conquer the world.
No.
They've got little barrels. Yeah.
So, but that's where it then starts becoming like the invaders, isn't it? Yeah.
Do you think they ever... lonely in that old nuclear bunker by themselves, thinking, should we have a game of Donkey Kong? You start hurling them barrels down
at us. No, don't hit it with the hammer! Don't hit it with the Oh, God.
Oh, there you go, Sid. I want to get to the kill screen. Anyway, let's not digress.
No, let's not digress. Don't know.
Next week.
Is there a next week? Oh, there is a next week.
Yes. It's on the chalkboard.
Oh, yeah. Look at the board of chalk. The all knowledge in chalk and board.
And next week, we're doing She-Wolf of London.
It says it all, really.
It does, doesn't it? No, I know nothing about this show.
No, neither do I.
I'm guessing it's a rip-off of American
Werewolf in London.
Yeah. I'm guessing.
Yeah. That's in England, in case you wanted to know that.
Yeah. It could just be a woman who's having a really bad hair day in London.
PMT day in London.
But one thing I do know about it, it is short.
And by God, we like that.
It's only like half hour.
Oh.
Half hour of programming. Oh.
See, this is what you can do. You can cram it in half hour. Yeah.
That's what War of the Worlds should have looked at.
Yes.
Wow, they did a lot in that. But what's the best program to do it in such a short time? Danger Man.
Oh, well, Danger Man. Well,
you could have fitted a whole James Bond plot into 20 minutes.
Oh, Danger Man.
Shown us you could.
Yeah, it was brilliant. Sheer brilliance, Danger Man.
You don't need all this small talk. Oh. You go straight to the facts. You only question the people who are relevant to solving the case.
Yes.
And you're in there.
And you don't need a large cast to do these things.
And you could film it in Port Mirren.
You could.
It could be Rome. It could be anywhere.
Downtown Rome or Port Mirren.